Good morning to all of you. Welcome to the free lecture series. Here now we are going to discuss the methods to minimize the armature reaction. We have understand that the armature reaction is basically nothing but the effect of the armature flux onto the field winding flux, and the resultant flux is going to be distorted. And there are two components called demagnetizing component or the cross magnetizing component, which may try to distort the main field flux. We have already seen that due to armature reactions, if the load is connected, in order to satisfy this load, the current is going to be flow in the armature. If the armature reaction increases, then the overall flux is going to be decreases by amount of 4 to 5%, and as a result, the inductive EMF also decreases. Now, in order to minimize this concept or to minimize the armature reaction, we are having two parts. First is basically the aseptic pole shoes. Generally, we have seen the pole shoes like this fashion. We have already seen this is the pole shoe like this. We have already seen in the already all lectures that this is like the kind of the pole shoes. It is the north and it is south. This is our armature. We in this kind of the pole shoes, we having the same distance from north to the conductors. It is always same. These are basically same distance. There is no change in distance. So this kind of the waveform will give say induced EMF or like this. This flat top, this is basically the this section shows that this is having a constant, the flux is coming from north to the conductor. And when the conductor reaches here, there is a change in this path, and the overall the flux changes. Aseptic pole shoes or the camphor pole shoes are nothing like this. Like this, we are just making the pole like this fashion, somehow stayed like this. In the previous case, we are making the pole like this. But this is called aseptic pole shoes. What is the advantages of it? How we can use it, that we have to understand. So let's put a rotor between the poles and then we can see the effect of it. This is called rotor. So by closely observing it, we can say that this distance and this distance is same. But this distance is going to be changed like this. It is not the same. Since we are making a eccentric pole shoe, so the flux which is coming from this section will having a higher reluctance path. This path and this path is basically higher reluctance. There will be large air gap. This is called, we are having a large air gap. Since air gap is increases at this area and this area, the air gap is increases. Since the reluctance is increases and the flux is going to be distorted, it will be decreasing. So the advantages of this eccentric pole shoes, we are just decreasing the flux at this point, this area, this point, this and this point. And we have already seen that the resultant flux is distorted and there will be maximum flux field due to this we having an armature reaction. If we are making this kind of the system, then we can able to decrease this resultant flux. So this is the advantages of it. Just by increasing the air gap, we are increasing the reluctance and the flux which is coming from the armature reaction is going to be decreases. So we can control the flux density at the specific conductor which may burn out. So it can be avoided by using, or it can be minimized by using the use of the eccentric pole shoes. This is our first effect that we are calling as a using eccentric pole shoes. In addition to this, the second, which is very important part, which is called the using of the compensating winding. Using of the compensating winding. So what kind of the windings is this we have to learn? The compensating winding is identical to the armature winding is put in the stator slots in the pole shoes and excited by the same current. That is called armature current. that we have to understand how the compensating finding will work. Let us consider this is our stator. Similarly, at this we are using this kind of shape. Here the rotor is having a armature winding like this fashion. We have already understand this is the armature winding in the rotor. And the load is connected here, so there will be armature current is flowing in the rotor or in the armature winding. You can see this cross, this is cross, this is cross, this is cross, this is dot, 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 this is the armature winding. In addition to this, we have put one winding that is called compensating winding, which is put in the rotor stator pole shoe, which is called compensating winding, like this fashion. And the direction of the flux or the induced EMF in the compensating winding is basically like this. It's having dot, 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 dot. It is basically cross. This is cross, this is cross, this is cross, the cross, cross. This is north and this is south. And the compensating winding is having the, it generates a MF which is opposite to the this armature MF, and we can easily remove this flux. So we can say that the flux which is been generated by the armature is called like this fashion, it is in the clockwise direction. The flux generated by the armature in the clockwise direction, like this direction. This is the armature flux generated. It is anti-clockwise direction. This is called the resultant flux. And this flux is responsible for distortion of the main field flux. And we have to eliminate this. In order to eliminate this flux, we have put a compensating winding in the stator pole shoes, and the MML generated by the compensating winding is opposite in nature. So this is the dot, so it making a field which is in the anti-clockwise direction. So the flux generated by the compensating winding like this, it is in the anti-clockwise direction, like this. It is like this, and from this section it is in the clockwise direction. So we have seen that closely, if we are observing this, then we can see that at this point the flux, the armature flux and the compensating flux are cancelled out. Similarly, the armature flux and the compensating winding flux is cancelled out. This is our advantage, is that by using the compensating winding, this armature flux is basically almost eliminated, and as a result we having a pathless commutation, or we can say that we having a very good effect on the fluoride side. So this is the advantages of the compensating winding, and it is always connected in series with this armature, like this question. And the current which is flowing in this armature winding and the compensating winding will generate their own MMF, but opposite in nature. So the MMF generated, we can say that the MMF generated by compensating winding is opposite to the armature MMF and cancel out. So this is the basic fundamental of the armature reaction, and this is the method which is can be used to eliminate the armature reaction. So I think you will enjoy this, and I think in the next class we will be discussed about the MMF diagram of this armature reaction.